Bossa Nova.
Bossa means the guy knows what he's doing, you know. They had a swing. 30 years before the Bossa Nova, I heard this phrase, you know, it's like a Bossa. My father used to say that all the time.
It's very sensual, it's very romantic, it just brings you into a different kind of a mood and makes you feel good. It's got a smile on it.
Jesus Christ, everybody was a galã, you know, everybody was a seducer.
We fly when we play. Do you know?
It's something very simple and yet very sophisticated and very creative, and it's a very noble music.
Because we are very shy, Bossa Nova, it was very intimate. We are used to the quiet sing, you know. We are not really singers, we are composers.
Isso é mais linda, mais cheia de graça. É ela, menina, que vem, que passa. Um doce balanço, caminho do mar.
It absolutely reflects what the country, Brazil, should have been.
Tall and tan and young and lovely, the girl from Ipanema goes walking, and when she passes he smiles, but she doesn't see.
Many of us know of Bossa Nova, if only through the catchy international hit, The Girl from Ipanema. Or perhaps as restaurant music, where it has played for the past 50 years, the background for countless meals and tawdry transactions. But listen a little closer, and you will hear sophisticated adult music. This novelty hit is just part of a barely known story, a quiet musical revolution. It began on the tropical beaches of Rio in the late 1950s, where a small group of musicians came together to create a new sound, a sound that would seduce the world.
Now, there was a legend in Egypt about the seven fat cows. You remember that? Moses, 7 years of great success in Egypt in the old times. In Brazil, it was the same thing. From 1956 to 1963, we had the fat cows here, the seven fat cows, seven beautiful years of economical development, political tranquility, and cultural development. Bossa Nova was a background, not only for music, but also, take note of this, Brazil had the most important theater at the time, the most important poetry, concrete poetry. Brazil had the most important literature. And not only that, in sports, Brazil was champion for everything. Brazil was champion for football 2 years, 1958 and 1962. Boxing, no, and the Jovem was even Miss Universe. Ieda Maria Vargas, a girl from the South, was Miss Universe. So everything, whatever you look at Brazil at that time, everything was great. Everything worked at those times. It was just like a paradise to live in Brazil at those times. There were no robbery, there were no drug dealers, there was nothing like that.
Ninguém manja ninguém. Até parece que não leu o Cruzeiro.
Não vai gritar?
The characters that would become the legends of Bossa Nova were an eclectic gang of musicians, poets, artists, and filmmakers searching for a soundtrack.
It's the time for Cinema Novo. It's called the New Cinema, you know, the Nouvelle Vague here. And the music had to develop. With so many things happening, music had to develop too. And the music that is very expressive at that time was naturally Bossa Nova. Why? Because Bossa Nova is the music from the middle class of Brazil.
I think in the beginning it was the middle class, because the guys who write music was people that had been to university, like Jobim, like Carlos Leira, all Vinicius, you know, everybody medium class.
Até parece que ela vai de samba, que ela vai no balanço do mar. Até parece que ela vai de samba, que ela não se cansa de samba. Até parece que ela vai de samba, que ela vai no balanço do mar. Até parece que ela vai de samba, que ela não se cansa de samba. Ela vem no balanço.
I was the guy that was there, the bus station when the bus passed. So I was not going to be a musician. When I was about my 15, 16 years, I thought I was going to be an architect. But when I heard the music that was being done in Brazil at that time, where it caught by surprise, it was just like Pearl Harbor, you know?
But that time, that high mid class that loved to buy the Sinatra albums, the Frank Sinatra albums, and all those jazz albums as well, they got in love with Bossa Nova, but was very small group of people.
We were not happy with what was happening in Brazil. The music was very, so we had to import. We would prefer much more to listen to Frank Sinatra, to Charles Trenet in France, you know, and other things like that, then listen to the Brazilian music of the time that was very heavy, didn't have that magic of the middle class for us. So we decided what we had to do. We decided to do the music ourselves. Let's do it, you know, for a hobby. We didn't intend to be professionals. So we started playing guitar, playing piano, you know, writing songs for fun, not to be professionals. And what happened? People start looking at us, we start getting very famous, and we start being professionals. You know, it was just like something that got us by surprise.
Rio que mora no mar, sorrio pro meu rio que tem no seu mar. Lindas flores que nascem morenas em jardins de sal. Rio, serras de veludo, sorrio pro meu rio que sorri de tudo, que é dourado quase todo dia e alegre como a luz.
Primeiro, esse grupo começou a se divulgar, né? E ser divulgado.
First of all, this group started getting to know by word of mouth, really.
Yeah.
They started talking about themselves, and other people started talking about them.
E nós íamos tocar muito nas faculdades, nos colégios, né? Divulgando nossa música.
So they started playing at schools and colleges so that they would let other people know their songs.
Turma da Bossa Nova ficou muito conhecida, ficou no Rio de Janeiro e São Paulo.
This group, they sort of met each other every day. No, he sort of corrected every night.
Yeah.
The new generation of well-to-do Brazilians has grown up with both the samba and the rhythms of modern life. Out of them, they have made bossa nova, and they have made it a part of their lives.
American TV captured the innocence of the early bossa nova movement in its own unique way.
There's something about this kind of music that seems to fit into a world of sports cars, hi-fi, and bikinis anywhere in the world.
Você você viu, só que amor, nunca vi coisa assim. E passou, nem parou, mas olhou só pra mim. Se voltar, vou atrás, vou pedir, vou falar. Vou dizer que o amor foi feitinho pra dar. Olha, é como o verão, quente o coração. Salta de repente para ver a menina que vem.
Bossa Nova was more than music. It was a celebration of romance, Brazilian beach culture, and sensual pleasure.
I would go to the beach. I was a surfer. Menescal would, how you call it?
Fishing.
Fishing, scuba diving, né? And so the sex that the women that would become would be very clean on the beach, you know, but nothing heavy, like in rock and roll.
Brazil, I mean, we have the sunshine and the beach and the, and you know, and the great rhythms. It's very sensual, it's very romantic, it just brings you into a different kind of a mood.
Jesus Christ, everybody was a galã, you know, everybody was a seducer. Jobim, as I was, you know, everybody was, Ronaldo Bosco, you know, those people, you know, women were fundamental. Women and whiskey. You know, it's like one photographer, Paulo Garcês, he said, this thing about drugs is something for the poor people. You know, the thing about putting cocaine on the toilet thing here, you know, and smelling all over, you know, on the toilet.
Rio today is a very different place. Ghostly echoes of Bossa Nova can barely be heard above the traffic. While samba schools still thunder through the streets at carnival time, Bossa Nova has become a kind of Brazilian folk music. But if you know where to look, there are memorials to lost heroes, like the flat of composer Tom Jobim, the bar where poet Vinicius de Moraes drank at, or perhaps you might even catch a glimpse of reclusive singer João Gilberto.
Welcome, sir. How is my name? I'll be very glad to take you around the city to the Bossa Nova sceneries. That's the day. Come in my car.
We go. Taking Atlantic Avenue. We're going to Beco das Garrafas, where they used to have very many different meetings, where they were just perceiving this new balance. It was Bossa Nova that came from the samba, kind of a soft samba, and with a big influence of the American jazz. Let's go for it. Bing, bong, bing, bing, bong, bong, bing, bong, bing, bing, bong, bing, bong. Sir, let me tell you something. Just now we are just facing to Nascimento e Silva 107, and this was the home of Nara Leão, very important musician and singer from those times. Podem me chamar e me pedir e me rogar, e podem mesmo falar mal, ficar de mal que não faz mal. Podem preparar milhões de festas ao luar, eu não vou. She received very many of her friends, all musicians, and her home was called, as joke, the bunker of Nara Leão. Eventually, when she left here, Tom Jobim came to live.
Que a Bossa Nova era tão, tão baixinho, tão, né, fechada assim. Então todo mundo cantava assim, né? Um cantinho, um violão.
After so many years, he looks back, and after looking back, he realized something that's very important. He just realized why Bossa Nova, when you sing Bossa Nova, you sing in such a low voice. Because, of course, outside Nara Leão's flat, everyone has to speak really low because the apartments were really tiny, and the neighbors were always complaining and banging with broomsticks. So they had to sing really, really low.
It was good because the people would get together all the time. all the composers, all the songwriters, big reunions every week. So you would write songs every week because you want to show to the guys there. I want to get to the next reunion with a nice song. And the same would happen with the other guys. So that would make you write all the time. That was very, and look for quality because you want to impress Jobim, you want to impress Vinicius. So you don't want to make a song that would sell. You want to take, what a beautiful harmony.
We didn't have a school, nothing to, but we had this school, the best, yeah. To Jobim's house, or Vinicius' house, or Carlos Lira's house, you know? That's the way we learned.
Someone to hold me tight, that would be very nice. Someone to love me right, that would be very nice. Someone to understand each little dream in me. Someone to take my hand, to be a team with me. So nice, life would be so nice if
everybody play the guitar and make music and we drink, but that was, we were not drinkers, you know? That was not the point. The point was the music. If Tom Jobim made one song or a new chord, we have to meet. Which chord is this? Oh, I see.
Você vê a diferença ao mesmo tempo.
You see the difference? At the same time, samba, we're still in the north zone where the houses are sort of, you've got lots of space between the houses and people could sing in loud voices, whereas in Bossa Nova was in Copacabana, really small voices.
Dias de luz, festa de sol, e o barquinho a deslizar no macio azul do mar. Tudo é verão, amor se faz num barquinho pelo mar que desliza sem parar. Sem intenção, nossa canção vai saindo deste mar e o sol beija o barco e luz.
The early Bossa Nova disciples may have been experimenting with this new jazz sound, but they were still looking for a frontman.
The most important elements of Bossa Nova, the melodies are very simple. They are simple. You can whistle the melodies. So it makes easier to people to sing. But the harmonies are very rich, very sophisticated. Then you have the rhythm, which was also very important. Two different rhythms. One that came from the guitar of João Gilbert. It was a samba, but another way of samba.
We didn't have the person to sing those songs like we did used to sing, because you used to sing very softly, and you're trying to get another way of playing guitar. When João Gilbert came, he brought a very great experience to us. He came with a new way of playing the guitar, a new way of playing samba, and he also came with an interpretation, a singing that was very soft, that was very delicate. And that's exactly what we want for our song, so we identified immediately.
Pois é, João Gilbert, com... Bing, bong, bing, bing, bong, bong, bing, bong, bing, bing, bong, bing.
There's many people that sort of talk on many songs, but for him, this song is just the seed of Bossa Nova.
É só isso, meu baião, e não tem mais nada, não. O meu coração pediu assim, só. Bim, bom, bim, bim, bom, bom, bim, bom, bim, bim, bom, bim, bom.
He came from Bahia. Yeah, that's a guy that came from poor people. João Gilberto came from, there's one of the case, the people that came from poor people, and he starts consuming Frank Sinatra and American music and French music and whatever else and the good music. And so João Gilberto grew up. He became a very important interpreter of Bossa Nova, to tell the truth, the most important interpreter of all times of Bossa Nova.
I think Bossa Nova is the first three albums of João Gilbert. That's the, I mean, like a definition would be that. And it's all made of, mostly of old Brazilian songs like Caymmi, Ari Barroso, Geraldo Pereira, some songs of my father, of Carlinhos Lira, and a new way to sing and to play the guitar, but it's basically samba like a cool samba or something like that.
Se você insiste em classificar.
João Gilberto performed Bossa Nova with a barely there emotional ambience and a subtly rhythmic guitar style.
Eu mesmo mentindo devo argumentar que isto é Bossa Nova, que isto é muito natural.
This is the theme song of a new wave in music. It's about a girl who likes sports cars and hi-fi, and a poor boy with a tin ear but strong feelings way down deep inside. The singer is João Gilberto. Both he and the song come from Brazil. But you don't have to dig Portuguese to recognize the key words, Bossa Nova, the new wave, the new beat.
I don't know, something looking for clarity, simplicity, and things like that. Although the chords are quite sophisticated, but it's very transparent. You listen everything, the one flute, one trombone, sometimes some violin that João used to do, like, when they would begin to play it.
Chega de saudade, a realidade é que sem ela não há paz, não há beleza, é só tristeza e a melancolia que não sai de mim, não sai de mim, não sai.
But Bossa Nova wasn't just soft ballads. It had another, harder side.
The Bossa Nova was very minimalist. Was a guitar, acoustic guitar, and drums with brushes, and everything was very... And my band was very... very spicy.
The Sergio Mendes Trio were one of many local acts that were combining jazz with Brazilian beats.
I started playing classical music when I was 7 years old, and then a friend of mine showed me one day a jazz record, and I fell in love with that kind of music and piano playing and the chords and all that, and we're trying to play those chords and to imitate those records then. Then Bossa Nova came, and I was already working some clubs in Rio, and that sound became very, very successful. I mean, not commercially successful, but became kind of a very hip thing.
The grooves that came from the trios and the groove that came from João Gilberto changed the samba. It was still samba, but another kind of samba.
Bossa Nova, ritmo que criou uma dança cheia de juventude. Dança verde, morena, sensual. Dança de Copacabana para o mundo.
Só dança samba, só dança samba, só dança samba. Vai, 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 vai. Só dança samba, só dança samba, só dança samba. Vai. Só dança samba, só dança samba, só dança samba. Vai, 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 vai. Só dança samba, só dança samba, só dança samba. Vai.
Música.
só danço samba, só danço samba. Vai, 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 vai. Só danço samba, só danço samba, só danço samba. Vai.
Although the melodies and rhythms made bossa nova swing, the Portuguese lyrics were vital to its seductive powers.
They say that they were running away from bolero and tango because all that was very sad and people gonna die because you don't love me. The lyrics were very... And the lyrics in bossa nova were a bit more like the sea, the sun, and but also sad.
The lyrics were always, I'm gonna drink myself to death because that woman, you know, she just screwed me and she went off with some other guy. You know, the lyrics were heavy like that. Bossa Nova is completely different. Bossa Nova is soft, gentle, the discreet charm of bourgeoisie. You know?
Quiet nights and quiet stars, quiet chords from my guitar. Floating under silence that surrounds us. Quiet thoughts and quiet dreams.
And the lyrics, also they have two very important lyric writers. One was Vinicius de Moraes, and the other one was Ronaldo Bosco. Vinicius, he would talk about love, but in a different way that people in the samba would say. Samba talks more sad. Now Vinicius was talking Amaro with hope. Okay, I want you to be my lover, blah, blah, blah. So it was more with happy.
He was always trying to put people together, and he would come to the beautiful girls who would go to the party and encourage them to, you know,
with somebody.
To go out with somebody. He was like a big Cupid. He was a very funny guy.
And Ronaldo Bosco were more with images, how you say, no? Like that was the sun, the sound, the south, the sea. It had this, like a movie, you know, very interesting.
You see that the most important lyricists are poets, like Vinicius de Moraes, and journalists like Ronaldo Bosco and other guys, you know, people that with culture, people with people that went to university. And, you know, it's very discreet, it's very charming, everything is very polite, it's very delicate, has culture, you know, has birth.
Of the simple melodies with sophisticated harmonies, with the grooves of João Gilberto in the guitar and the trios, and the difference of the lyrics of Vinicius and Ronaldo Bosco, that was what made the bossa nova.
This American reporter took time out from the beach to give his version of the burgeoning scene.
The bossa nova has been hanging around in this alley in Copacabana for a long time, a new cult waiting for some members. The tourists all walked right by on their way to the big nightclubs, where the samba reminded them that they were in Brazil, and where the twist reminded them that by jet they're only 9.5 hours from the Peppermint Lounge. That left this place, the Bottles Bar, to the kids, the ones with the expressionless faces and the understated way of smoking a cigarette. But nice, romantic kids, not at war with anybody, like the music in the Bottles Bar.
This is the very end of the aisle, where bossa nova really started. Just nowadays, it's a strip club, completely different from 40 years ago. For the neighbors were very unhappy when the sound was too loud. And were just throwing bottles out the window because they were upset with the club downstairs. So it was called at the end Pico das Garrafas because garrafa is just bottle in Portuguese language. That's what it is. Sir.
Bocos Bar was a little and most important bar, that little place, 80 persons, 100 persons every night there, and 500 persons out.
Very mellow, very bohemian, small little club, I mean really small, an upright piano, and my drummer and a bass. I started with a trio, Sergio Mendes Trio, and that became kind of a, every foreign musician that was in town used to come to the Bottles Bar.
Copacabana, a orla marítima mais deslumbrante do mundo.
The thriving Rio club scene saw Bossa's trios mixing it with balladeers, while visiting American jazz artists might leap from the audience to take the stage. Out of these sweaty boxes, Bossa Nova's next generation emerged.
4, 5, 6 nightclubs with big shows, Lenny Andrade, Peri Ribeiro, Luiz Carlos Vinhas, Sergio Mendes.
We're very shy, Bossa Nova it was very intimate. We are used to the quiet sing, you know. We are not really singers, we are composers, eh? We sing our songs, but not in big places. So we prefer small places.
Everybody walking around to see one, see another one, and call and call. Look, what is the sound that I found? You have to see that group.
When you have a good style or if you're a good artist, they say, well, this guy's have a bossa. So the Nova was added just, I remember young, 5, 6 years old, listening to the generation of my father talking about bossa. Oh, this guy is, he have a bossa. Bossa means the guy knows what he's doing, you know, they have a swing.
My generation was crazy about that. We went to all the concerts, we bought all the records, and it was lovely information to get as a teenager, that kind of music. So it's not a surprise that so many good musicians came out of that. Like Marcos Valle, Dori Caymmi, Edu Lobo, all those guys were fed by Bossa Nova, I mean, breastfed by Bossa Nova.
Yeah.
So, and so was I.
Um cantinho, violão, esse amor, uma canção, pra fazer feliz a quem se ama.
I think the beauty of Bossa Nova is that it's something very simple and yet very sophisticated and very creative, and it's a very noble music. It absolutely reflects what the country, Brazil, should have been.
One of the heroes of the new wave is Antonio Carlos Jobim, who wrote Desafinado, the Bossa Nova theme song.
This is just a little samba built upon a single note. Other notes are bound to follow, but the root is still that note. Now this new one is the consequence of the one we've just been through. As I'm bound to be the unavoidable consequence of you.
If Bossa Nova had found its Jesus in João Gilberto, its God was Tom Jobim, a songwriting genius who effortlessly composed much of the movement's songbook. This rare footage captures him at his peak.
So I come back to my first note, as I must come back to you. I will pour into that one note all the love I feel for you.
The guy dies, but the music stays, and you still have It's a bit like talking to the guy. I think he left something alive, like the music.
Antonio Carlos Brasileiro de Almeida and Jobim. So he has Brasileiro in his name. Everybody loves Tom Jobim. Everybody loves the musician. Everybody loves the composer. Everybody loves the man. And a lot of women used to love this doctor, Antonio Carlos Jobim.
He would sit at the piano and play you a song. You just, I mean, he was the ultimate seducer because, you know, you would just start crying. You couldn't stop because it was beauty after. It was just beauty, you know, the way he wrote, the way he composed.
He was, for me, the God. He wrote pieces from the end of the 50s, unbeatable songs, incredible songs, that I heard. I was 13, 14 years old, and I was like, oh, my God, what the hell is that? I want to be like this man.
We used to make jokes with him, said, Tom, you're not that important. You're not that important all over the world because you're only the second most important composer in all the songs you write. You're only the second because the first are the Beatles. And he says, don't you forget, there are four. Beatles are four, and I'm alone.
It was Tom Jobim, together with poet Vinicius de Moraes, who wrote the song that would put Bossa Nova on the world stage.
Moça do corpo dourado, do sol de Ipanema, o seu balançado é mais que poema, é a coisa mais linda que eu já vi passar. That's how it goes. I'm not a singer.
Tall and thin and young and lovely, the girl from Ipanema goes walking. And when she passes, each one she passes goes, ah. When she walks, she's like a samba that swings so cool and sways so gently that when she passes, each one she passes goes, ah.
The girl from Ipanema played in cafes, clubs, and restaurants the world over. Even Hollywood couldn't resist this easily digestible music. Astro Gilberto mimed the song in a ski lodge for a B-grade film. It was a long way from the hot streets of Rio, where it was first conceived.
Next corner, where the composer wrote the girl for an Ipanema song, as he was just sat down, wondering, at the sidewalk, and there she was, coming from the sea. She never gave attention to him, though.
Tall and thin and young and lovely, the girl from Ipanema goes walking, and when she passes, he smiles, but she doesn't see.
He used to joke a lot, singing like, oh, but I watch her so sadly, and then he would...
Your father.
Singing in short. Yeah, and a Russian guy. I was in a tour with the Quarteto Morilembao. The guy calls me to the hotel. I was in Italy, I don't know. Then begins to ask me about the girl from Ipanema. Saying, but how is the girl? Is she beautiful? And I was saying, no, the girl is any girl you want to. For me, it's a different girl. For a boy now, today, it's gonna be looking at a new girl passing by, and the story is all the same. But the guy, no, but the real girl, was she fine? said yes, she was very beautiful. But what was she healthy? I said yes, very healthy. And then finally the guy said, was she blind? Because you have the thing, I smile, but she doesn't see.
She just doesn't see.
The magic is in the song. When you hear Garota de Ipanema, when you hear the magic of Stan's saxophone and Astrud, the way simply that she sang, and beautiful that song, you know, I think that captivated the world.
For a jazz album, never sold like that, it was... What happened?
I think the fact that Jobim had English lyrics written for his songs, I think was a very important component for Brazilian music to be a little more into a different level.
Musicians came here and they heard, the jazz musicians. They came here and they began to record.
Jazz gave us everything, the harmony, and we gave to them the rhythm with what we learned from them. So I think Bossa Nova was very good to the jazz too.
Some of the Brazilian songs, I think they also had a wonderful life. As far as penetration in different cultures, because they had good translations. I mean, the Girl from Ipanema, you might like or dislike, or Quiet Nights, or How Insensitive. And I mean, the fact that allowed people like Sinatra, Ella Fitzgerald, Sarah Vaughan to sing that song in a language where everybody understood, it internationalized the song.
And then they went to the U.S. I mean, my father and a lot of people, they did this concert in Carnegie Hall. He went in the same day of the concert because a council from the diplomatic thing said, okay, everybody's going, if the boat's gonna sink, you're the captain of the ship, you have to sink together. So he went.
Bossa Nova was given the full Coca-Cola treatment. Tom Jobim was concerned enough to comment on camera while in America playing with local jazz artists like Jerry Mulligan.
We had the Bossa Nova ice box, Bossa Nova washing machines, Bossa Nova lawyers, you know, and many things. And now I heard here in the radio, Bossa Nova hair con, Bossa Nova shoes. No, this is not very good for the music.
The thing they did in the U.S. when it began to become popular, they wanted to make it like a dance, like Haligali, like something.
Here is Bossa Nova on Broadway. Its interpreter, a dancing master called Killer Joe.
Quick, quick, slow. Quick, quick, slow. Quick, quick, slow. Relax your body. Relax yourself. It's not a wild dance, it's not a jumpy dance.
And there's this video of the Americans learning the steps of the Bossa Nova dance, which never existed.
Bossa Nova, you may be relieved to hear, is not supposed to be another twist. According to members of the cult, it's not even supposed to be a dance, only for listening. But Arthur Murray is teaching Bossa Nova in a hurry.
Left, right.
In the very beginning, Bossa Nova was considered non-commercial music. Nobody wanted to record. Then when Bossa Nova sell,
mm-hmm.
Then everybody started to record Bossa Nova, you know, and then, you know, the thing was a little bit... commercializada, you know, I don't know how to say.
You just said it.
There was a time in the 60s that people were doing Brazilian music. They would get the theme, Girl from Ipanema, tap 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 tap, and immediately go that goddamn improvising, you know? That distorts the whole music.
And the Americans, it got worse, you know? Like, we had to listen to albums like guys like Charlie Bird, Bossa Nova, which is awful. Awful. Terrible.
And that was not Brazilian music for a start. Even with American people playing jazz, sometimes they get too much now me music, you know? Listen to me, mommy, how smart I am, you know?
The difference is the phrasing, Brazilian phrasing, something very subtle that not anyone can catch. Because the phrasing, for understand about the phrase, I think you have to be here, you have to live with these people, you have to go to a soccer game in Brazil, you have to go to the Ipanema beach, there's something very special when you speak about phrasing. Phrasing, for me, is the essence of Brazilian music, what makes it different from other types of music.
In the wake of the bossa nova wave, Brazilian musicians were flying high around the world. But back in Brazil, the music's innocence was about to be lost.
Bossa nova.
The time of Ipanema, it was nice. It was much less violent than Rio is today. But then we had the problem with the government.
20 anos depois de iniciado, o ciclo da revolução de 1964.
In 1964, tanks rolled through the streets of Rio as the government was overthrown in a military coup.
É o que promete este jornal.
The dictatorship spoiled everything we built from 1956 to 1963. Everything was destroyed practically, and now we are paying until today. To this day.
There was nobody in the streets. So strange. And then suddenly, horses, and you know?
War.
God, what a time.
And we were closing the studio. We didn't know anything about it, what was happening. They closed everything, and they started to kill people. That's why everybody went away. And this reflects in the culture.
There was no more bossa nova. There was more nothing in Brazil. They got the mediocrity, took over with the dictatorship. That's why Jobim stood in the States, didn't want to come back anymore, and Sergio Mendes went to the States, and a lot of people got off Brazil and stood there for many years.
My son was born 6th of April of 64, the day of the revolution. And it was like, the times in Brazil was not great. I mean, for artistry, for the artists, for the music, and everything was very... And I said, I want nothing to do with that. I'm out of here.
As the bossa beat fell silent in Rio, It was left to entrepreneurial musicians like Sergio Mendez to keep the groove going. But it would be kept alive in exile. Sergio Mendes would become the most successful Brazilian artist of all time. His explosive version of Mashquenada was the first of many international hits.
It's more of a chant, it's more of a sound song. When you say, oh, ari, yo, bao, bao, ba, that's really the meat of the music, and there's no meaning. I mean, you might have said, oh, it's the Yoruba dialect, or Mashquenado means more than nothing, or forget about it, but people don't even use those expressions, so there's no poetical meaning in the song. It's just a feel-good, sing-along, unique international chant.
It's always good, no matter where you put it. You can listen to it anywhere you want. It's good music, it's eternal. There's a nice sentence of a famous Brazilian poet called Carlos Drummond de Andrade. In a rough translation, it would be, I'm tired of being modern, now I want to be eternal.
After his death, I worked a lot also playing his song around the world, going weird places and where you would never imagine people would know the music, and people know, they sing the lyrics, they do. The lyrics, they sing the song.
Even with that kind of censorship and all of that, and people were thrown in jail and all of that, but just, I mean, the music continued. I guess that was the force of the culture.
Samba Samba, I lost up maybe $100,000.
Guess who was doing therapy with me?
Tom Jobim?
John Lennon.
Really?
John Lennon was doing the therapy. That, you remember when he came out with those records? Mother, the thing. Because the primal therapy was this about. You used to go into a room and you would scream, Mother, you screwed me, Mother. And John Lennon wrote Mother, that song, you know?
So what else can we talk about? I'm getting a bit drunk.
No, it's okay. I mean, that's basically it.
Tall and tan and young and lovely, a girl from Ipanema goes walking, and when she passes, each one she passes goes, when she walks, she's like a samba that swings so cool and sways so gentle, that when she passes, each one she passes goes, ah.